Hey guys, welcome back to another grocery haul. It has been a while, but if you are not new, then you know that I mentioned that we are preparing to move. And so life has been a little bit crazy. I've not been buying very much, but I do need a few things and I thought I would take you with me. I was not planning on grocery shopping right now, so pardon my appearance. I'm not really apologizing for it, because that seems weird, but you know, I wasn't anticipating grocery shopping right now, but I went to go do something else where I wasn't gonna be really in public and couldn't do it. So I was like, all right, let me just go run and do some grocery shopping. So I got to run into a Lidl for a couple things and then Aldi, and I'll take you with me, see if there's anything new. I have no meal plan to share with you. I'm using whatever meat I have in the freezer. My husband has started a new job, and with all of this change right now, this won't always be this way. He's not always home for dinner, and so I am making something and like eating it all week for myself kind of deal. It's just kind of all over the place, but I'm using up what I have in my freezer, my pantry, so I'm really just getting fresh items. I do look forward to kind of getting back into a groove and sharing all of that with you, but let's head into the store and see what we can find. I got lots of stuff to do, so I gotta stop the rambling. Those of you who don't have a Lidl near you and you've never been to one, I just thought I would show you a little bit inside the store. It has the aisle, you know, like at Aldi it's called the aisle of shame or the Aldi finds aisle. They have that plus actually a lot more. So I just thought I'd take you through a little bit of that today. Some really pretty wrapping paper, lots of items, random stuff, clothing, stuff for the home, dishes, kitchenware, entertainment things like serving dishes and things like that. And it changes all of the time. They also have like toys. I thought these were some really nice toy options. They're all like wood. Well, not all of them, but the ones I'm showing you right now are really good prices for just some kind of cute little, I don't know, random things, play food, little kits that I think it's like a doctor's kit, a tool kit, and like a hairdressing kit, something like that. Anyways, lots of fun random things. You never know what you're gonna find there. And there's probably like 2 to 3 times as much of like that part of the store as there is in Aldi. And so I really like Lidl. I definitely shop there and Aldi. But if you have a Lidl near you, I definitely recommend checking it out. They've got some really good deals using their app, and they kind of do, it seems like they do coupons that kind of cater to you. When you use their app, at least that's what it seems like. I actually get coupons for things I actually would use. Sorry, I just said actually a couple times. Anyways, here's just a little peek inside of Lidl, and then we are gonna head into Aldi. Right, so the last couple times I came to Aldi, I've been there on like the last day of the sale, so I haven't been finding a lot of things. So I thought it'd be fun today to take you through, because I was there on a better day of the week, and some really cute shoe options. I believe I've purchased, no, I know we've purchased shoes before at Aldi, and you know, don't snooze on it. So they had some winter boots. I actually really like these. I bought myself some last year, but I really like those better than the ones I bought myself, but I just bought some last year, so I'm gonna keep them and not buy anything else. They even have some faux leather leggings. You guys, they've got a little bit of everything. Now, the clothing area tends to get kind of a mess because people are just messy going through it, but they have these cute pajama sets. They're like a 4-piece, a shorts and a t-shirt, and then it looks like a tank and a long sleeve pair of pants, not long sleeve, long pants. Some cute fleece character jackets, I guess they're, I think they said they were jackets. I found a couple other characters I'll show you in a second, but some slippers, they had some fleece lined clogs, and this was on clearance for $4.99, and it was super soft. This poncho, there's more of those character fleece jackets. So lots of stuff. Sometimes, like I said, the clothing area can get a little bit of a mess, but just look through it. This is a few things that I've already seen in the past, so I just skimmed past it really quickly. This rug, there was only one of them left at my store, but they're very soft and a really good size for, I think it was $50. This dog bed, I'm not a pet person, but boy, does that look comfy. If I had a dog, I think I'd want to get that for him because super cozy. And we've got pillows, fire safe, you know, all of the random stuff that they have, but I did find some Christmas stuff, so hang in there. We're gonna take a look at that in just a second. I thought these were Squishmallows, but I'm not really up on my thing here. You know, I'm not on the toy game, but these were huge, but they kind of felt like Squishmallows. Anyways, they were enormous, and I just thought I'd show you them a little bit because, you know, maybe you've got a child into that kind of thing. These socks, they had them in men's and women's. It's a 3-pack, and they are some nice thermal socks, and I love the colors on them. They were so soft and cozy. I really should have got myself a pack of those, but, you know, I'm not allowing myself to buy anything right now. This comforter set was really nice. It's reversible. It was super soft and cozy, and then there were some more shoes. So I'm not sure why. Maybe it has to do with what stuff is new and what stuff is old, but I felt like today my store's stuff was a little bit mixed up, but that happens sometimes. This Sherpa little handbag was cute. It's not something I personally would use, but it's cute, and it came in 3 colors, the dark tan, the white, or the cream rather, and then it also came in black. They definitely had lots of cozy stuff, whether it be a little, like this is just, I think it's called a lounge wrap, something nice and cozy. Lots of good things for the colder weather, mostly women's and then some children's. There's a few things in men's, but mostly women's. These sweatshirt dresses, I don't know, I like the second pattern I show you a little bit better, but I don't know if it's something I personally would wear out, but I think it'd be cute with leggings or maybe even just for around the house. These long cardigans I thought were really, really pretty. Once again, I liked this one here, the second one. But here's some men's lounge pants. So lots of stuff for the, you know, the cozy season, some children's fleece pajamas in all different popular characters. So yeah, slippers, all of the cozy things. If you're looking for something cozy, Aldi has it. Lidl had quite a few of the things as well. But yeah, lots to look through. But they have lots of stuff for the kitchen. This stuff is kind of intermingled, so it's kind of feels like it's a little all over the place. But pots and pans, utensils, spatulas, and then we're back to some cozy socks. I think these were like those slipper socks that have the little rubber things on the bottom. But we've got a roasting pan with a rack. If you are hosting or entertaining for the first time, check Aldi. Large bamboo cutting board. I think mine might be from Aldi. It might be that exact same one. I love it. I have it actually used mostly for decor on my counter. But all sorts of little things. There was like a baster in there, mini baking dishes. But if you, between like the roasting pan and the rack and all of those other things I showed you, great stuff for hosting a dinner, but then also just for hosting company. We've got these pretty flameless candles, a mop, little garbage cans, but lots of stuff for your guests. We've got some air mattresses, including this child's air mattress that has a built-in pump, and it has like a, it's almost like a little boat. Like it has a rim around it, you know, if they don't roll off of it. We've got heated blanket, which I think I actually showed you earlier. It was in 2 different spots. Some really fun Christmas sheet sets, whether this is for you and your family or for your guests if you're having some company over Christmas. And then here we are to some Christmas decor pieces. We've got the boots and the sleigh. I love the little sleigh. This is something in the future I want, but like I said, I'm not letting myself buy anything right now. But this little bathroom set, and they did have a variety of styles I was able to show you a little bit. We've got the tree, the presents, the gingerbread, and then there was also the gnome, which was also in the front. And it looks like this comes with like a bath mat, two hand towels, and the hand soap. I really actually just want hand towels, Christmas hand towels for my bathrooms, but that's a really cute set. These paper trees, they're just paper, but they're really, really pretty. And just a few other pieces here. This large bell I thought was really, really nice. So something larger that makes a statement. And then they also have these pre-lit trees. There's a few things here that I think are a star. I love this angel that lights up. I also love those little deer in the back. They light up as well. Those are kind of one of my favorites. And then we have the plates and the bowls. I think both were only $4.99 each. These sweet little village houses for $10 or $9.99. And then these flacked pieces. I know this is popular this year. I imagine they all come in different colors. I think I would go for the tree in either white or green, the angel in red or white, and the snowman in white. I just think those are really pretty for $6.99. And then some fun Christmas mugs, the tree, the gingerbread, the snowman. I just love all things Christmas. In case you can't tell, I thought these battery-operated lights were so cute for $4.99, and they had so many varieties. Santa, gingerbread men, penguins. I found these little red truck ones with the tree in the back, and then snowmen. Oh my word, so cute. Those would be really fun on like a tiered tray. And then I love these little snow globes. I was trying to be careful because I didn't want to break anything, and I felt like they were kind of just set in here haphazardly. But there was one in the back here that was easy to grab. And as you can see, great snow in there. And then it is a music box as well. There's a wind-up thing at the bottom. So very pretty. These light-up ornaments for $3.99. This snowman, he's seen better days. He got chipped pretty bad. But a little elf. I mean, there's so many varieties. This ribbon is an excellent deal. $10 for 50 feet of ribbon. And they have some really pretty patterns. My favorite, if I was buying anything right now, would be that red velvet. It's a little bit thinner, but I love it. And then there was these ornament sets, and that kind of wrapped up what they had for Christmas. Okay, so I am back home. This is all I got. I picked this up at Lidl. I picked up the rest from Aldi, some tissues, some tortilla chips. I didn't have the ones I normally get, but that'll be fine. Pineapple and some grapes. Just like to have a little bit of fruit on hand. I'm also using my frozen fruit in the freezer. I'm almost done with that. Just like I said, trying to use up stuff. Some orange juice, some almond milk, some vanilla almond milk creamer. Vinegar, that is for laundry. Some eggs. I've been eating eggs most days, so I didn't want to run out of those. Some dark chocolate chips because I don't really have a lot of sweets at the house. So, I don't think I want to do any baking. I mean, we still have a little bit of time left, but like at home, I don't know. I don't really think I want to do baking, so probably just snacking. And some sourdough bread. I'll put this in the freezer, but for eggs and toast or sandwiches or to go with dinner, it'll be all those things, and I'll just keep that in the freezer. That is it. I think I spent like $40 combined at both places. Just to give you a glimpse, it's real. We are moving. So I've begun packing, and that has been keeping me busy. All right, well, that is gonna do it for this video. I do have a question for you folks though. If you could let me know, because I'm deciding what I wanna do with this channel. I know I haven't been posting much with everything going on, but I wanna continue sharing grocery hauls, and I'm wondering about bringing back any recipe videos. I don't know if they would be like a what's for dinner or like something like that where there's like two or three recipes in it. Please let me know in the comments if that's something you're interested in, or if you're just here for the grocery hauls, that's fine too. It's better for me to know what people are here for. And also, do you check for on YouTube on your subscription feed or your home feed? If you don't know what I'm talking about, let me know that too. But I'm gonna tell you, if you're on your home feed, you may not see people you're subscribed to. You really have to go to the subscription feed. So I'm just curious how people are utilizing YouTube and what all can be affecting views. I know right now I've just not been posting regularly, but I'm just trying to get a gauge and decide what I want to do. All right, that's it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.